Welcome to this video demonstration of processing of sputum specimen for culture for diagnosis of tuberculosis. We'll first look at the importance of processing sputum specimens before culture test. A good sputum specimen has mucus strands in which most of the bacteria are trapped. Sputum has a lot of common bacteria that colonize the throat and can contaminate the culture. Bacterial content in the sputum needs to be concentrated to achieve a good detectable growth on culture. So, processing of sputum lyses the mucus strands and helps in obtaining a homogeneous solution. It kills the contaminating normal flora and concentrates the bacterial content in the resulting pellet. We'll first look at the techniques that are generally used for processing sputum specimen. One is the modified Petrov's method that uses 4% sodium hydroxide, and the other is NALC-NaOH method that uses 1% NALC and NaOH at a final concentration of up to 1.5%. In this demonstration, we'll be looking at the N-acetyl-L-cysteine method of sputum processing. The steps that are involved are, first we have to prepare the reagents that are 4% sodium hydroxide and 2.9% sodium citrate, which are prepared separately, sterilized, and both reagents are mixed in equal volumes. For example, 50 ml plus 50 ml to obtain the working reagent. And 1 gram of sodium N-acetyl-L-cysteine is added to the working solution freshly. Equal volume of N-acetyl-L-cysteine NaOH is added to sputum. Mix it gently by inversion and vortex gently for 30 seconds. And it is allowed to stand for 15 minutes with intermittent checking and gentle mixing. The content is then neutralized with phosphate buffered saline at pH 6.8. The sample is then centrifuged at 3000 G for 15 minutes. The supernatant is discarded and the pellet is used for inoculation in culture medium. We will now be looking at the procedure. These are the reagents and the powder that are used for the process. First is 4% sodium hydroxide, second is 2.9% sodium citrate and N-acetyl-L-cysteine powder. It is preferable to use this powder every day freshly, which can be packed in a small packet and brought to the laboratory. And then we have phosphate buffered saline at pH 6.8. Here we have two specimens which are going to be processed. The sample contains about, the tube contains about 3 ml of sample. So, about equal volume of freshly prepared NALC-NaOH mix will be added to the sample. Care is taken to see that the tube or the solution does not touch the mouth of the tube. Once the reagent is added, the content in the tube is mixed gently by inversion. Mixing it by inversion, make sure that all sample that is trapped under the lid is brought into solution. The mixing has to be gentle because a vigorous shaking or vigorous mixing will result in the oxidation of the NALC powder, and which may not result in a good homogenized sample. The tube is then vortexed for about 30 seconds gently. The sample is allowed to stand at room temperature for about 10 minutes with intermittent checking. At the end of 15 minutes, the tube is verified to see if the sample is completely homogenized. If at this stage we find some strands that are not digested, we can add a little pinch of the NALC powder to ensure homogenization. Now, these samples are completely homogenized. This is now neutralized by addition of phosphate buffered saline up to the 50 ml mark. By doing so, the action of sodium hydroxide is neutralized. The sample is now ready for centrifugation at 3000 G for 15 minutes. The centrifuge buckets are brought inside the cabinet as part of the biosafety precautions. The tube is placed inside the buckets. The outside surface of the centrifuge buckets are wiped with the disinfectant. Usually it is about 5% phenol. This ensures that any aerosol that is generated is neutralized completely. After wiping the external surface with 5% phenol, the buckets will be taken to the centrifuge and centrifugation will be done for 15 minutes. Once the centrifugation is completed, the buckets are brought out, the sample is removed and the interiors of the buckets are now wiped with the disinfectant. This is very important because any aerosols that are generated during centrifugation, if the cap of the tube is not closed properly, that will be eliminated by this treatment with the disinfectant. Now, the centrifugation is completed, the supernatant is discarded, taking care to see that the pellet is not disturbed. You now see the pellet is there at the bottom with a little bit of the phosphate buffer. The pellet is now ready and it can be used for inoculation onto LJ or any liquid medium like midget 960 tube, or it can be used for any molecular testing. With this, we come to the end of the video demonstration of specimen processing for sputum culture. Thank you.